This rugged ground is looking towards restoration, sweeter song. Come salvation, ever true. Make me believe things can be new.
Hi, my name's Marissa Garcia. Back in September 9th, 2011, we got married. And that was the best day of our lives. All of our dreams had come true. My wedding was my dream wedding. Everything was awesome. We were planning to buy a new house, new furniture, new everything. And November 20th of 2011, he got really sick. We thought it was just a flu that he had. And so we thought, okay, we're gonna go to the hospital, he's gonna get medication, and we're gonna leave. It's right before Thanksgiving. Everything's gonna be fine. We show up to the hospital, and they tell us that he has to stay overnight because his blood pressure was extremely high, and that the doctor would come talk to us the next day. The next day, the doctor didn't show up till about almost 7 o'clock. It was a Sunday, so we kind of expected that. But we expected him to leave there with maybe now high blood pressure medication because his blood pressure was extremely high and he had been placed in ICU. So we wait for the doctor. The doctor shows up and all he says to us is, your husband has kidney failure, he needs dialysis immediately and a surgery. If not, he's gonna die. I think at that point, both of our hearts fell into little pieces. We felt lost. We had no idea what kidney failure was or what it even entailed. I had no idea how I was even gonna pay for anything. I had no idea what was gonna happen from then on. The next day, on Monday morning, he gets a surgery to insert the catheter on the right side of his chest. And that catheter is to put into the dialysis machine to be able to clean out your blood. And that happened, and that same day, that same Monday morning, he gets dialysis for the first time. Then he got it again 2 more days after that. When we left Methodist, they told us that they could no longer help us since he had no insurance, and that we would have to go to Bentaub Hospital. Come to find out, Bentaub only gives you dialysis on emergency basis, and you have to meet their criteria. And basically the criteria is you have to be close to dying in order to get dialysis there. So for the most part, my husband should be getting dialysis 3 times a week. He gets it about once a week, if not once every 2 weeks, which makes him for the rest of the time extremely sick, throwing up, he can't breathe, and there's no life. We have gone recently to Conroe Regional, and at Conroe Regional, we are able to get dialysis there also on an emergency basis, but they don't have a criteria, so they can help us a little bit more. But most of the time, Jonathan has spent his time, his days are at the hospital. My husband is 27 years old, and if he doesn't get a transplant, he's gonna die. We have a 6-year-old daughter. Every day she asks, is Daddy okay today? Or do we have to go to the hospital again? Or what are we gonna do this weekend? And then she'll say, oh, never mind, we're probably gonna be at the hospital again. It breaks my heart. There's things that I can't tell her or say. I don't know what to do. I need help. I'm currently the only one working in our household. I make enough to make ends meet. Other than that, I don't. And we're going to be throwing other fundraisers, so you can tune in. You can also email us at helpjonathan2012@gmail.com. I need help financially. We've been talking to St. Luke's Hospital. That's one of the transplant centers in Houston, Texas. And they are asking for $150,000. I need your help praying for us, giving us strength. If you have ever gone through anything that I have gone through or know what I'm talking about, I ask for your help. I need it more than anything. Thank you so much. God bless you.
see the dark and hate it all. The wounded hand and broken child. Surely now you hear their call. Surely God, you feel it all. 'Cause heaven is here in little ways. Can't wait for the day when you come.